Hello, fellow vapers. Vape Pound here again. Just wanted to get a new video up. It's been a while with the holidays, Thanksgiving, Christmas, you know, New Year's. Just been really busy. First of all, I do want to say I hope everybody had a great holiday season, that you spent time with family and friends, no matter what you celebrate, that you had a good time and a safe time. What I want to do today is something a little bit different. It was about a month and a half ago or so that my wife and I went up to the Windy City Vapers meet and won a Omega for my wife. This is the newer version of the Omega, the version 1.1, and it's a little different when you look at it side by side to the older one. This is the older one here, and you can see it has the three set screws that hold the top on, and the newer ones don't have that. And there is a really great video out there by the creator of the Omega, CDDZ75 on YouTube. Does a great job explaining how to take this apart, clean it, maintain it, because the Omega is an amazing mod. We won't really go into that other than I give it a 10 out of 10. Hits every time. It's all mechanical. Love this thing. I loved my wife so much that I ended up finding a used one from Darren's Den on Twitter and picked it up. He sent it to me. The finish isn't as great and nice as the new one, but you know what? This is kind of my outdoors, treat it rough mod. Don't have to worry about it. I can beat it up, and it's still going to hit every time. It might not be as pretty, but it's going to hit every time. And hit like a champ. So this is what I want to talk about. This is my wife's Omega. Like I said, there are no set screws there. So, oh, sounds like the mailman just showed up. So this is what we've got. Let's go ahead and get started on disassembling, cleaning, and putting back together. Okay, and here we have my wife's Omega. Like I said, this is a newer version. I have my older one here that I had picked up secondhand, and you can see it's pretty rough. The older ones had a different finish on them. I believe it was a nickel finish, nickel plating, that tended to tarnish pretty easily. This one here is, let's see, we were up there in December, so about a month, month and a half old, and there has been no tarnishing. It is, you know, chrome here, so we gotta, hey, you're gonna have to wipe off fingerprints, but other than fingerprints, there's nothing wrong with the finish at all. We haven't had to polish it with anything, just a rag to clean off the fingerprints is about it. So, with that, you have version 1.1 of the Omega. To get started here, I'll go ahead and take off the drip tip. That's 306. There is your connector, and there's a little bit of juice in there. My wife likes to use a 306 with just a straight drip tip on it without the drip shield, at least on this particular mod. With that, you're going to get a little more juice in there than what you would if you used an impaired drip shield on there. But nothing there that's not too hard to, you know, I just take a little bit of a soft rag here and just kind of clean it out a little bit in there, just like that. So, you know, that looks pretty good to me. So, okay, we're going to go ahead and take the battery out. Inside there, that is your battery tube. You got your spring down at the bottom. Pretty simple. Omega there, in the end of it. And it does have two vent holes, one on each side of the Omega there. So, in case of any type of battery failure, you're safe. Okay, so this is your head unit. This is your switch, connector, everything all in one. Okay, on the inside here, you're going to see this, I think it's Delrin or some type of a plastic disc. Pretty much the easiest way to get that out. Let's pop that once or twice there, and that comes out. So that's all that is. It's there to protect, to make sure that your battery does not make contact with the center pin, and we'll just set that off to the side. I will take and using a rag, just do a real quick wipe down on that, make sure there's no juice or anything on there. Okay, so we'll set that there. Now, when you look inside there, you can see that there is a nut down there. The pin that you're seeing, hard to do this on the camera, it's kind of reversed for me, right here is your center pin. Now, you want to be very careful you don't bend that back and forth or do anything to that that would damage that or take it off of the center pin on the atomizer connector there. So you will notice that those are directly attached. If I push or move the center, the bottom, pushing on the bottom, it will, I guess it's hard to see on camera here, but it will affect the pin on the atomizer connector. Now, when you're trying to get to that nut that's down in there, it's a little difficult. You may find a thin-walled socket that would fit down in there. I didn't have a thin wall to get down in there easily. I also didn't want to do any damage by using any needle nose pliers or anything like that that I may accidentally put too much force in or maybe scratch up the sides. What I found that works for me is this pair of kind of heavy-duty tweezers that we had laying around in the vaping box. They're spread just about perfectly here to go on either side of that nut. And just like that, they're on either side of that nut. Like I said, you can find other ways to do this. This is what I found that works. A thin wall socket would probably be the best way to do that. But unfortunately, I didn't have any sitting around the house, and a regular size socket didn't fit down in there for me. So what you're going to do is go ahead and very gently unscrew that nut. And when you bring it out, you'll see that it's more than just a nut. Here in a second, I'll show you. Okay, now that I got that out, besides being a nut, it holds the whole head together, the head unit of the Omega together. So we'll set that off to the side here. When you do that, now you have these two pieces that are can now come apart. So we're going to pull off the top piece here and look on the inside here. Okay, what you've got is your spring, which I will go ahead and pull out very gently. And there, this is all one piece here now. This is as far as you're going to be breaking this down, okay? At least as far as I'm willing to break it down. Okay, if you look inside there, you may see there's some condensation, some moisture. Inside of the outer metal piece here, there is a Delrin bushing. That helps these two pieces to slide back and forth against each other not stick or anything like that. So what we'll do is we'll just set these out together now so you can see all the pieces. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, there's the five pieces plus the battery tube. It looks like a lot going on here. It's really very simple. Once I get these pieces kind of cleaned up a little bit, we'll go ahead and throw it back together and show you how to do it. First of all, we're going to go ahead and clean off all these pieces. Once again, I've just got a nice soft dinner napkin is what I'm using. Cloth dinner napkin, and just make sure that you get, you know, all make sure everything in there is clean. You can go ahead and clean out the threads because you will put more Noalox in here before you put it back together. So actually, I don't know if I will today because I don't know if I've got any Noalox sitting around the house right at the moment. I think I need to go buy some. I only had a small sample size, and I think that it is gone. Okay, that one's done. It's going to do the same thing on the inside here. Actually, what I'm going to do on that one, so I do have some Q-tips here, and there's nothing in there that's going to grab the fabric off the Q-tip or the cotton off the Q-tip. So I'm just going to go ahead and make sure that's all nice and clean in there. You can see I had a little bit of juice that had gotten in there. Just make sure it's all nice and clean. Okay. On Chad's video, CDDZ75 on YouTube, he talks about actually taking and using some sandpaper if you see any corrosion or anything on that spring. This mod is new enough that there is no corrosion. I'm not going to worry about that at this point in time. The little nut contraption here, I want to make sure that it's clean as well. And you'll see it also appears to have what would be a bushing. What that allows it to do is a slide up and down easier on that center pin that makes contact with the battery, okay? Because this is what really kind of moves up and down along that center pin, and you want that to be as smooth as possible. Okay, so we've got all the pieces cleaned. We're going to go ahead and put this thing back together, okay? First thing you want to do is go ahead and put your spring back in. If you look in there, there's a little seat there, a piece in there that's cut out a little bit more. Right there is where your spring sits down into. You get it down in there, and it's just going to sit perfect for you. Sits right down in there. No problems with that at all. You put the bottom part of the head back on. Okay. There you go. See, you make sure you got smooth motion there. Make sure you don't have any debris in there. Here's what you're going to be able to tell. You'll feel it if you have debris in there that's going to cause it to not do right. Now, you're going to take this piece, put the thread in first, and it's going to go right over that center pin. Okay. And see how that's in there like that. Okay. Now I'm going to go ahead and push this down together. I'm going to go ahead and put my tweezers on that nut. And I'm just going to screw it in gently. Just, you know, you don't want to over tighten it. Get it finger tight. Okay. As you can see, put back together and they're just fine. Okay, next piece, you're going to put this last little piece back in here. The easiest way to do that, put that in there, push it down. What you should be able to notice is that you'll be able to feel that center pin connector coming up just above that black plastic there, okay? After that, put the battery back in. Make sure you go ahead and clean your threads here. Right now would be the time that you would go ahead and apply your no-locks onto your male threads. Screw it into the female back and forth a few times. Get that taken care of. Make sure that's all on there good. But I'm going to go and put the battery back in. Put the atomizer back on. There you go. Hits like a champ. So that's how easy it is to do. The big thing is with a mod like this that has that mechanical connection, you want to make sure that you keep that maintained. As it's new, I mean, there's no set schedule, anything that you need to do. But like I said, we've had this about 6 weeks, and about a week ago was the first time that I took that apart and did it. It didn't need to be done again today, but I went ahead and did this for purpose of the video. I'd say we'll probably clean it about once every 4 to 6 weeks, and just to maintain it, make sure that everything in there is as new looking as possible. So if you're interested in the Omega, I would definitely recommend picking one up. I've got a ton of other mods. And my wife has a few others that she uses. We're really happy with the Omega. It hits like a champ. It hits every time. Takes a little getting used to the top button like that, but once you do, it really does work well. Well, that's all I've got for you. Hope that you enjoyed this and it was a little bit of informative for you. Remember, vaping is a way of life. Share the life. We'll see you next time. Take it back to the days of just showing.